Hey everybody, I'm Kevin Michalowski, editor of Concealed Carry Magazine. Did you not love that killer intro music? I didn't know that was coming. It was rolling in my headset right here. We are talking about the new age of gun ownership. I mean, we just saw 3 million new gun owners come online in March. And what I've done now is I've reached out to Eric Hung, the founder of Pew Pew Tactical. And we want to talk about this new age, about what's going on out there in the world of gun owners. So Eric, welcome to the show. I really appreciate you being here.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Yeah, we're looking at strange times in the gun world lately. You know, through the month of March, we saw, 3 million new gun owners coming online, overwhelming the National Instant Criminal Background Check System and stuff like that. And I started thinking, what do these people need to know right now? So I wanted to reach out to somebody who is out there talking to new gun owners regularly through your website and your emails and stuff like that. What do people need to know? What's happening?
I think the main thing is if they're looking for a gun, to sort of just know the laws for their state. I'm in California right now, and tons of people have reached out and said, like, hey, I actually have to take this safety certificate and then wait 10 days. What's up with that? So I'm like, okay, there's actually a thing called gun control that a lot of people voted in. So I'd say look out for that. Once you do get your firearm, definitely make sure to follow the four rules of safety. And hopefully I remember those. Otherwise, that'd be embarrassing. It's the gun is always loaded. So treat it as if it were. Keep your muzzle pointed where it's safe, or anything that you intend on destroying, that's where the muzzle is pointed. So just watch out for that. Third is keep your trigger off, keep your finger off the trigger until you're ready to shoot. And lastly, just be aware of your target and what's beyond it. Besides those... Mm-hmm.
I just always like to remind people that what's in between you and your target as well, too, because, you know, there's all kinds of, you know, you're responsible for every bullet going down range. So,
yeah, exactly. And like those are the two more serious sort of things to know. But I'd say probably a third one is just that, like, movies are wrong for a lot of things. When you shoot a shotgun, it doesn't just hit like everything downrange. And unfortunately, your magazines aren't infinite or anything like that. And I'd say probably maybe like last tip is just practice, especially for your first time with a buddy who's pretty familiar with guns, or ideally take a class. I know that's a little hard right now, so you'll have to make do.
Yeah, a whole lot of the social distancing stuff is kind of getting in the way of our training, and maybe we'll talk about that a little bit later on. I want to go back to something that you mentioned. People were surprised at some of the gun control laws, which maybe they had voted for, especially out there in California. This is getting to be a pretty interesting time. People are waking up to what it really takes to buy a firearm, and we have this discussion a lot that it's not easy or anonymous to buy a gun, even if you're buying from an online retailer or something like that. There's a lot of hoops people have to jump through. Can you talk to us a little bit about that?
Yeah, exactly. I think one common misconception is you can just go online, enter your credit card, click, and then a gun just shows up on your doorstep. And people are definitely finding out that is not the case. You really have to go to FFL or local gun shop and do your background check, fill out tons of info, and then if your state has a waiting period, wait that, and then you get your gun. So people are just finding that out right now.
Yeah, way too many people were believing the media reports that, you know, the nation is just awash in guns and they're just so easy to get. And you just run down to the gun store and, you know, they load up your duffel bag with guns and you get to walk home. That's not the way it works. And I tell people all the time that, you know, you can't just go buy a gun and strap it on your hip and consider yourself protected. You talked a little bit about practice, practicing with a buddy or learning some stuff. I really like some of the emails and your website, things like that are sending out. What sort of stuff should people be looking for, especially new gun owners, that kind of helps them along their way from, you know, being a brand new gun owner to someone who's a little bit more confident with what they have?
Yeah, I would say, like, look through, like, probably watch some YouTube videos or read some stuff on your specific firearm. Actually know, like, how it works. I think that's really important. And then also get, like, a lot of correct gear. You don't have to spend tons of money on great gear, but you ideally want to spend a good amount of money on something that's that works for people. I'd say especially get, like, a good gun belt if you do intend on carrying either concealed or outside your waistband. I'd say get good ammo. Mm-hmm. I definitely, I cheaped out on some ammo at, like, reloaded ammo at, like, gun stores, and those just didn't work very well. So I'd say definitely Don't cheap out on that. Don't cheap out on magazines. And also get more ammo and magazines that you thought you would need, because you always run out when at the range.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And I'm a big proponent of having, you know, thousands of rounds of ammo just sort of laying around just in case, one of those sorts of things. Tell us a little bit about your story. How did you get involved with firearms? And honestly, what made you want to found Pew Pew Tactical? How did this all get started?
Yeah, so I was always really into firearms growing up, but just being in Los Angeles, not a lot of people had them. I think I maybe shot a 22 when I was in the Boy Scouts, and that was it. And I really got into guns when I was in my 20s. So I got a Ruger 10/22 just on a whim, shot it one time, and said, okay, I'm hooked, and just got really, really into it. And as soon as I did, all my close buddies wanted to get in on it too. And so they started asking me the same questions over and over. I thought, okay, I'm just going to set up a blog and write a few posts, and then at least, I don't know, a dozen people will read it. And it just kept, I guess, snowballing. Kept writing more stuff, more people were reading it. I spent an inordinate amount of money on guns and gear, and this was obviously before I was married. Now I can get to say that it's a business expense, so it's still good. I still get to buy a lot of stuff. I was really, really lucky to be able to quit my day job and just work full-time on this after a few years. So I think that was in 2018. Just started hiring writers, hiring like in-house editors. Shout out to David, Allison, and John on the team. We're all working remote right now. And I think just the original mission statement was to teach people that maybe didn't grow up with guns, just how to get into guns without being condescending or anything like that. Like anytime we use terminology, we tend to say it out in layman terms too. So just, trying to create something that I would have wanted back then.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's exactly one of the things I have to be careful with. I have to not assume that everybody knows what I know when I'm talking to them. I've been doing this, I shudder to think now, professionally for nearly 30 years. You wouldn't tell by the look of this face, you know, I don't look that old. But it's, I love the fact that you started out with a Ruger 10/22. What made you pick that gun? Why was that Eric Hung's first gun?
I don't even know anymore. I think I wanted a 22 just to start off with, and it seemed like one of those that you can upgrade a lot. And I think this whole upgrading, finding the best upgrades thing, that's followed me through like a lot of our top articles are just best upgrades. Because I really love that stuff. I think a lot of the aspect of shooting is it's really down to you, but some upgrades help here and there. So.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's kind of fun to get out there and buy new stuff. So that leads me into one of your discussion points, I guess it would be, or something that I wanted to talk to you about. When I see notifications from Pew Pew Tactical, a lot of, I guess we'll call them listicles or top 10 lists or top 5 lists or stuff like that. Anything coming to mind immediately that, you know, a brand new gun owner should know, should go to your site and read about or something like that?
Yeah, in the past like few weeks and even like a month or two, we've been seeing a huge spike in a couple articles, and they all sort of go towards the beginner. So like best beginner handguns, if you search for that on Google, will rank probably top one or two. And it's just, I think, just really, real beginner people looking for handguns, and they don't know anything. So if you read that article, you'll know like what's a caliber, how to grip it, how to choose the best one for you. And of course, we have a couple recommendations. And besides handguns, there's also people, like whenever you think about like home defense, self-defense, people say like, okay, just get a shotgun. And so people are looking for shotguns as well. And I think those are maybe skewing a little bit more towards like the pump actions or just more affordable options. I think affordability is something that everyone's thinking about as well. Obviously people are also looking for AR-15s. That's always on top of everyone's head. And so that article is doing really well as too. We're seeing like just online retailers sell out of almost everything they have, especially guns and ammo and magazines. So it's going to be kind of hard. Like even once you get past, if your state has gun control, a lot of strict control for your gun, you're going to have problems getting a lot of ammo, a lot of mags. So it's just how it is right now. It's crazy.
Yeah, it's one of those things that you probably should have started doing before there was an emergency or before a whole lot of people started doing it as well. I'm going to put you on the spot right now. What would you select or what have you selected for your home defense firearm? What do you use or what do you recommend?
Yeah, so for that, it's usually, I'd say, take a look at how your house is laid out, like other family members, and I think it comes down to what you're just most proficient with. So for me, it's just a Gen 3 Glock 17 with a light.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and that's pretty much exactly what I carry too. I'm a Glock 19 fan. That's my favorite gun, and I my everyday carry gun is equipped with a light and laser. It's a Viridian C5L, and I keep that near me at all times. And when I go to bed, it's near the bed. It's something I can get to very quickly. And I love the idea of a handgun as a self-defense weapon because it's small, it's lightweight, it's easy to maneuver if you're in a hallway or going through a doorway or something like that. And in a practical sense, I don't ever again in my life want to shoot an AR-15 indoors. My ears were ringing for days afterwards. I mean, the muzzle blast and the report on something like that is just a little bit crazy. So, and you talked about people meeting up with buddies or talking to other folks. Let's talk about that a little bit. We have a whole bunch of gun owners, you know, maybe 100 million of us out there who are kind of looking at this new surge of gun owners, maybe even a little bit askance. Certainly not me, but there's probably some other older, dyed-in-the-wool guys who are like, all these new people, what are they supposed to do? And my suggestion would be, you know, go to the range and meet some folks. And well, as soon as we get the opportunity, but have you seen a lot of, you know, what I would call, you know, traditional or longtime gun owners really reaching out and trying to help the new gun owners?
I think it's a mix. There's definitely the memes out there that are pretty well thought out. But basically, there seems to be a little bit of gun owners that are saying like, okay, I told you so. You should have bought these way back when. If you need guns, you're not going to get them from me. But I think they're probably the minority. I think the main majority of gun owners, they're really open to it. If they have a gun buddy who's asking like, okay, what should I get for the first gun? Like, will this work? How's this ammo? I think most people, they're really happy to help too. So I'm glad that's, I feel, is the general spirit of the gun community right now.
Yeah, gun owners typically like to talk about what they believe in, and whether they're a 1911 guy or a Glock guy or a revolver guy or you know, whether a woman wants to carry a or use a 20 gauge for her home defense gun or if she carries in her purse or on her hip. I think a lot of folks, especially with a little bit more experience in this, are kind of comfortable talking and welcoming new people into the crowd. So what other stuff are people talking about on Pew Pew Tactical, or what are you talking about? I did notice, I saw something about gas masks popping in there. So I'm thinking accessories or is there other elements? Is it more than just guns that we're talking about on your website?
Yeah, like we started dabbling a little bit into survival, and one of the articles that really popped out was best gas masks. For that mm-hmm. one, we had like a bunch of N95s that are all over the news now, and then all the way down to like military ones where they have a better cheek weld mm-hmm. for shooting rifles and everything mm-hmm. in between. And so that was another article that just really, really spiked in terms of organic traffic, like people looking. And so, mm-hmm. yeah, people are just trying to get as much protection as they can for themselves, like either in the gun world or from just like viruses or dust or anything else. So people definitely are looking mm-hmm. for gas masks, and there's it's out of stock too. So mm-hmm. wish we could be like yeah. more help for people.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, there seems to be a buying frenzy with everything in the world going on right about now. I happen to be one of those people who, for the longest time, I've dabbled in precious metals, and now it's, you know, people are buying silver bullion or gold bullion like crazy, and I'm noticing that, you know, prices are fluctuating and everybody's out of stock, and it's, you know, whether it's rice and beans or gas masks or precious metals or I consider ammunition a precious metal too, you know, brass and lead and stuff like that. It all seems to be going. So thanks for joining us on this special USCCA broadcast with Pew Pew Tactical. We are living in an incredible time to be a gun owner in America, and more people than ever before are exercising their Second Amendment rights for the first time. When we come back, we'll talk about a list of do's and don'ts that every gun owner needs to think about. Stay tuned. We'll see you soon.